Here are the 10 most important questions from transportation model. 1. For finding an initial feasible solution in transportation model or in transportation problem, which method is used? Option A, simplex method, BGAM method, least cost method, or Hungarian method. The correct answer is least cost method. Now, to get the initial feasible solution in transportation problem, we use either northwest corner method, least cost method, or Vogel's approximation method, which is abbreviated as VAM, which is also called as penalty cost method. Moving to the next question. For finding an optimum solution in transportation problem, which method is used? A, simplex method, BGAM method, MODI method, or Hungarian method. Now, the answer is MODI method. Now, to get the optimality test or to get the optimum solution, we use either stepping stone method or MODI method, which is called as a modified distribution method or UV method. The transportation problems deals with transportation of single product from a source to several destinations, several products from a source to a destination, single product from several sources to a destination, and option D is several products from several sources to several destinations. The answer is D, that is, in transportation problem, we can, or rather we consider, various sources which are supplying products to the various destinations, and there could be several products which are being transported. In northwest corner method, first allocation is made at option A, lower right corner of the table, upper right corner of the table, highest costly cell of the table, and upper left hand corner of the table. So the correct answer is upper left hand corner of the table. Now, if you take a look at a typical example of this transportation problem, and if this is the cost matrix or cost table, so we make first allocation at this point, which is at the upper side and left side corner. One disadvantage of using northwest corner rule to find the initial solution to a transportation problem is that A, it is complicated to use, it does not take into account the cost of transportation, it leads to degenerate initial solution, it may provide wrong solution. The correct answer is that it does not take into account the cost of transportation. Now, if you take a look at these three different methods that are being used for getting the initial feasible solution, this northwest corner method do not consider the cost element, rather least cost method or this penalty cost method consider cost, so they give a better answer as compared to the northwest corner method. When the total demand is equal to supply, then the transportation problem is said to be balanced, unbalanced, maximization, minimization. So the answer is balanced. If we take a look at this problem, here you can see that the demand and supply have both a value of 210, right? So meaning is that this is a balanced transportation problem. The dummy source or destination in transportation problem is added to number A, balance the transportation problem, prevent solution from becoming degenerate, ensure that the total cost does not exceed a limit, and the last option is the solution not be generate. The correct answer is that to balance the transportation problem. Right, now take a look at this example. Here you can find that the particular supply is greater than this demand, right? So we have to add a dummy column at this point to make this particular problem a balanced transportation problem, and then only we can solve this kind of a problem. The solution to a transportation problem with m rows, that is supplies, and n columns, that is destination, is basic feasible if number of positive allocations are m plus n, m into n, m plus n minus 1, and m plus n plus 1. The correct answer is m plus n minus 1. Now, if you take a look at this example, now here you can find that there are 3 rows and there are 3 columns. So 3 plus 3, 6, and minus 1, that is 5. So this solution, to be a basic feasible solution, you need to have a 5 number of allocations. But if you take a look that 1, 2, 3, 4, there are only 4 number of allocations. So this is not a basic feasible solution. And this kind of solution is called as a degenerate solution. The maximization type of transportation problem can be converted into minimization type by subtracting the smallest cost element from all other cost elements, by adding smallest cost element to all other cost elements, by subtracting all the unit cost from the highest unit cost of the table, and the last option is by adding smallest cost element to all other cost elements. The correct answer is C, by subtracting all the unit cost from highest unit cost of the table. Now, if you take a look at this example, first of all, let us try to understand that the usually transportation problem is of minimization type. If it is been asked that this is a maximization type of problem and to maximize the profit, the first thing that you have to do is that find out from this cost table what is the highest cost. So in this table, the highest cost is 11. So we have to subtract all other elements from this 11. So this element will become 11 minus 8, that is 3, or 11 minus 7, that will become 4, and likewise. In applying Vogel's approximation method, row and column penalties are determined by finding the largest unit cost in each row or column, finding the smallest unit cost in each row or column, finding the sum of the unit cost in each row or column, and the last option is the finding the difference between the two lowest unit cost in each row and column. The correct answer is D. Now take a look at this example. So if we are applying VAM method or Vogel's approximation method, the penalty for this particular row can be calculated by considering the difference between two smallest element, that is 7 and 3. So the penalty will be 4. For this particular row, the penalty will be difference between 8 and 3, that is 5. So similarly, penalties are calculated as a difference between the two lowest unit cost in each row and column. Thank you.